Hello and welcome. Today I'm playing Space Engineers. This is a personal favourite game of mine, so I was like, you know what? I'm gonna make some ships for you guys. Now, since people like playing on survival mode, I was like, well, what we might do is build some small, compact drones that you can use to ruin other people's day. So, first one, the grinder. Destroy their stuff, and then take it for yourself. The rocket one. Deal a crap ton of damage, but you're gonna have to put rockets in it. But it can reload itself, I think. Haven't tried it in survival. I'll try it later. Third one. Anti-personnel. Or small ship. Now you can imagine getting attacked, like this sneaking in to like your big carrier base, and then just destroying all your little ships like, to battle, and then they just go, they walk into their hangar, and then there's this little guy with a little smiley face on, and all this other shit's just blown up and just destroyed and floating about, and then it just like flies away out of the hangar. Then you can launch their attack against it. Now, I was testing it a little bit up there, so they are kind of effective. But the first one I'll be testing is the grinder. Now, I think that this one is a little bit harder to make because of a grinder, I'm not too sure. But, you know what, they're still pretty small and cheap, shouldn't matter too much. So, in a survival situation, these ships would be pretty good because of just the pure cheapness is to make them, so you can be a wee cheap bastard and make loads of them. So if the guy finally kills a little pestering one that's like been annoying him for ages, you can just go, not today, and then bring another one out and kill him. Now this one's more so for kind of attacking someone's ship and then getting inside of it and then destroying it from in there where the defenses can't hit you like a little noob. Which is actually kind of funny, and then as soon as you deal the damage, take out his reactor, destroy some important bits, you can just retreat away with all his resources. Saying, if you knock it when his reactor, say, he's like, just happily flying around, reactor goes off, inertia dampers don't work anymore, and he just flies into an asteroid and dies. Which is just what you want for an enemy. Now, the hole that these make, you can't actually fit through it, so easy to get inside the ships. Now where's the platform? Now this is probably the worst for movement, I would say. I mean, it's quite a slow little sluggish thing. So definitely seeking up, maybe put like a custom paint, kind of paint job on it. Try and camouflage it as much as you can. Maybe put a projector block, try and camouflage it in. That might be a good idea for this ship. Oop. But anyways, the second ship, my personal favourite. Now this little thing here is just brilliant. It's just actually brilliant. Now where the, oh here it is here. I was kind of messing around with them a little bit. If I just get into the ship, enter, and remote control. Right, there we go. Now a little funny story that came with this ship is when I was building it, since it was on a wee landing gear on the platform, I accidentally hit, well, I clicked, and then the whole thing just blew up the front of it and just destroyed my station. Which really wasn't fun, because I needed to go and build it again. But, oh, this is just brilliant. Destroy so much of someone's stuff with this. Well, I would say the only weakness for these little small ships is if someone's got a, like remote control turrets, but even if then you can still probably spot them out, then sneak around behind them, and then just like surprise attack them, and then they'll just be like, no, and then it's too late, and then all their stuff's blown out. Even trying to like sneak this in, they got like a really, if they're being stupid and they put like their command seat for their ship like out in the open or on the outside of their like their spaceship, just sneak up behind them, just boom, one rocket. Controls down, they can't move the ship anymore, you just take it, probably maybe raid your crew with whatever kind of crew raiding ship you've made, and then you've got all their stuff, you've got their pretty much intact ship, except for the cockpit, which you'll be able to easily make back, even scavenge some stuff off their ship and just scrap it. Now, the third one I'm going to be showing you is my little anti-personnel kind of one I was kind of thinking of. So, say someone had like a little sneaky asteroid base, and they're just sitting there, like, camping it in there. You could just, like, sneak this in, or use, like, a miner and mine in one side to their base and just send a couple of these in with your mates, and then just go on, like, a little, like, rampage that go into their little corridors and, like, their, all of their stuff, just shooting up their little planes and just generally being a little arse. But these would, and since they're that cheap, you can just dispense. If you got a whole like stack of them, you could just send a whole bunch in. One dies, send another one in, and the amount of damage that you would cause by this, because since it'll be inside their base, it would probably be a lot harder for their teammates, or not their teammates, but their ships to actually shoot these things. So it's a lot more actually effective than you would think. Ah, here it is. Oh, come on. Let me in. Where's the control? I'll put on it. Ah, there it is. Ooh, come on. Come on. No, come on. There we go. Control. And one. Now, this is, like I'm saying here, I'll show you a little demonstration. If you just fly, see, you flew it in here. Fly in. So you fly it in here. Oh, Jesus Christ. You see, you fly into the ship, you just start destroying everything. Isn't there, like, you can actually kind of shoot things quite well with this. But it does seem to destroy these blocks rather well for some reason. So imagine the damage that you would cause. And they wouldn't know what was hitting them. They would think, oh, this attack is outside their ship. But nope, you've already snuck in like some little parasite and you're already feeding on them. Which is a little arse thing to do. But this ship's just good for killing people. I would more so say that's probably the best. Now, say there was a, I'll show you, say like a situation, the blue ship that is cut in half because I'd done it earlier, it's coming towards you. You're like, oh crap, send out a couple of these drones, which that is pretty far away, the blue ship, but it's not the 5,000 cap. But if it was further, you can just build like a little beacon, a wee kind of midway antenna, which will basically make it so that you can easily cover up the distance. Now, see, if you get up to this ship and you're like, right, see, this isn't broken. I fly in here. You've got like a ship. You just shoot up the ship. That means they can't retaliate back to you. And say if you even had like a timer block and a like explosive, like a mine, you could fly in here, attach the mine of say landing gear, set the timer on it. Or not really, set the timer for like say 5 minutes or whatever you can set it to, whatever you want. Fly in here, stick it in and get out. And then it just blows up a massive hole in their ship. Which is just brilliant. But I'm gonna try and work on even maybe like a smaller ship that I can use. That's even more basic that I can use for say breaking down or getting through really small corridors for you. If you want any of these ships, just ask in the comments and I will put them up in the workshop for you to use. But I'll test them out in survival first and make sure they're all good ready for you. Now, where are we going to go? Actually, no, I'll quickly test out in a mining carriage. No, that already got that one. Now, what I'll probably do is I'll probably end it right here and then I'll cut back to when I'm actually at it. Right, back a minute. Right, I'm back. I'm within about 700 meters now. Now, oh no, I forgot that they have a 5,000 meter cap. See, that's the only problem they have. They're not really meant. So what I would intend for you to do that would be a good idea would be to round your base, set little kind of beacons and all that kind of stuff. So create like a kind of map of just, you can send drones out wherever you kind of want. I think the Glassdan Gamer's done a good one on that. It's like a little beacon that you can use. It was that was either Video Sage, it was Last Night Gamers, it was one of them. But if you look on his videos, you'll see you can make little kind of halfway beacons and then basically send out your drones wherever you want. But hopefully this has gave you some inspiration for some new video, or for some creations of your own, little troll devices, little cheap, easy and affordable. Now, until next time, hope you enjoyed, and I may have messed up. I said until next time first. Until next time.